Hey guys, we're the Screen Team, and we are back with a review of one of the most anticipated films of 2017. We're talking about the brand new Justice League movie produced by the folks over at Warner Brothers and DC. And to help us with this review, we've got Sean. Sean, good to have you on the show.
Glad to be here.
Now, last week, you and I were on the show, and we were talking about Thor Ragnarok, which is a film we liked, but we were wanting more for it. Critically, and
apparently everyone else
loved
a lot of it.
We were the Grinches of Thor Ragnarok. Are we the Grinches with Justice League?
I don't know.
Did you like the film?
I thought it was better than Batman vs Superman.
Okay, well, that's not saying much, man.
Okay, it was all right, mildly entertaining, but I don't think it was a good movie.
Right.
I mean, there were some spot, like, you could tell progress was made, especially coming from Batman vs Superman.
Mm-hmm.
You can tell progress was made. They brought in all the Justice League characters. I thought Flash, Aquaman were real good in this. I thought, you know, Batman was the Bruce Affleck Batman. I thought he was fine in Batman vs Superman. He was fine here. Mm-hmm. You know, let's see. Cyborg, I thought was all right.
Okay.
He could have used a lot more characterization. I thought he kind of got the short end of the shrift there. Let's see. Wonder Woman was, if you saw Wonder Woman, the movie Wonder Woman, you know how Wonder Woman was. They didn't really change much there.
Right.
I feel like I'm missing someone.
Dun, 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 dun. Dun, 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 dun.
I'm just gonna let you keep singing now.
You better stop me, because I mean, I'm gonna have to like pay John Williams for singing that, man.
Okay, yeah. Hey guys, spoiler alert, Superman's in this movie.
What did you think about his development?
I don't want to get too far into it without, you know, because it's spoilers, but you know.
All right, Superman. All right, so we've got Justice League. The world's being tried to take over by this villain called Steppenwolf, right?
Yes.
Steppenwolf and his band of moths.
Bugs?
Whatever they are.
Flying ants?
Whatever they are, they feed on the fear of their victims. So Steppenwolf's trying to take over the world. Who's going to stop him? Hopefully our heroes in the Justice League. As Sean pointed out, we've got Aquaman, we've got Flash, we've got Cyborg, Wonder Woman, and
Batman and Superman.
Batman and Superman, you know, as well. The two big ones as well. I wasn't a fan of this film, Sean.
Okay, let's get started. Steppenwolf, awful.
Awful villain, I agree.
Awful. Completely awful. Just, he's like, oh, I want to destroy the world. And that's all the information you get about him. That's all he tries to do throughout the movie. No stakes, no added stakes, no kind of personal. They got a little bit of personal connection. That's more to the people that Aquaman and Wonder Woman come through, not through them themselves.
Okay.
I thought the plot was bad. I thought that they did not learn from the Avengers. Because they tried to push, oh, we're going to develop all these characters that you know about, you have not seen before.
Correct.
Here in this one movie. And it made the beginning of the movie drag really hard.
It was, that first act was so boring.
It was, man.
So boring. And they're trying to introduce so many, like you said, so many people we're not familiar with in this cinematic universe. And it's done very poorly.
It's hitting just rapid fire. You're barely getting any kind of character relation. You know, oh, Barry Allen's weird. He's funny. So he has that going for him. But hey, he's weird. Oh, Aquaman's a boring loner over in Norway or Scandinavia or wherever he's at.
And he's ticked off for some reason. Yeah, why is he mad?
They never really go into it. And, you know, oh, Cyborg is kind of a robot. Which is literally, I think, the entire characterization they have for him throughout the film.
Right. It's fair to say that we should point out for those who are listening and those who are watching right now that this production went into two different entities of some sort. This film was directed by Zack Snyder. Zack Snyder, I think, pretty much completed a lot of the film, and Warner Brothers was kind of like, we need to go in a different direction. Mm-hmm. And Zach had to leave for personal reasons.
Yeah.
So they got your boy.
Yeah, Joss Whedon.
The guy who directed The Avengers, which is one of the greatest.
Avengers, Age of Ultron, Buffy, Angel.
One of the greatest, you know, comic book movies of all time. And they came him to do not only reshoots, but all, to kind of change the story as well. They wanted more focus on Wonder Woman in this particular film. So you can kind of tell by knowing that information and watching this film where a lot of the story points don't connect very well. Mm-hmm. It seems very choppy.
It's disjointed, like, and the humor is better than Batman vs. Superman, which had no humor. So they brought in some humor bits, mainly through Flash and Aquaman, which was good. Of course, those two also look like the only ones having fun in the film.
Right.
You know, Batman was his dour self. Diana, Wonder Woman, was kind of more dour than you would hope.
Yeah.
And, you know, Superman's dead for most of the film.
You know, when I started liking this film, wasn't in the first act, wasn't in the second act, was around the third act, where you're getting a little deeper into some of our characters. Wonder Woman's having a tough time whether or not she should lead the group or not. Bruce Wayne is having a tough time whether or not he even wants to do that. He's getting old. You know, he's getting bruises and scarred, and he thinks that his time is coming to an end. And they're coming, the group is coming into conflict on whether or not they should resurrect one of their pals.
Yeah, and that brings me back to the Avengers problem, is the Avengers did all that stuff at the end of the first act.
Right.
While Justice League waited till the beginning of the third act.
Right.
And it made the beginning of the movie very hard to get through. It's like, no, they did it better the other way. They showed you how to do this.
Yeah.
And it's just, the opening of the movie, also, it keeps a lot of the Zack Snyder dour tone is really prevalent through the beginning of the movie. And that does not help you trying to get up for this big superhero movie.
Yeah. You know, for a movie that had all these iconic characters in it, it was very, very hard to get into, very slow, boring in some parts. What does the DCU do now? Where do they go, man? What do you do?
According to rumors, there's not much else for there to go.
Because this movie's been out for a couple weeks, and it's not doing very well in the box office. This was supposed to be their huge hit for the the end of 2017, and this film was going to decide where they branch off to and where they go. And what does Warner Brothers do now?
Well, I mean, there were signs of progress here. I mean, you could tell they were starting to get the tone right as we got towards the end of the film. Once they teamed up, I really didn't have that much of a problem outside of the villain being awful.
Right.
Once they got all together, I thought, okay, you know, this is all right. This is showing a path forward to the future. And we know there's an Aquaman movie coming up.
Next Christmas.
Yes. There's a Shazam movie, I believe, was in.
Dude, there's a lot of films that are in production, but that's what I'm saying. You know, I mean, a Suicide Squad 2 movie is in production. A Gotham Sirens movie is in production. A Wonder Woman 2 is in production.
You'd have to imagine they were going to try to get Flash and Cyborg.
Flashpoint is one of the movies in production. There was supposed to be a Cyborg film scheduled for 2020, but this was a few years back. I don't know if that's even still going to happen or not, but if they want to do a Cyborg movie, they need to really flesh out that character a lot more.
That's a good pun there. You didn't notice it, Bob.
No, I got it, man. I got it. I'm with you.
I liked it. I was with you
there. Danny Elfman did the score, and you could hear some twinges of some classic of it, I wanted to hear the whole thing.
I was like, oh, that sounds like the Batman theme for a second, then it was gone.
It would have been cool if they would have kept it for for 10, 15 seconds where you could have been like, and got into it, made it fun.
Yeah.
You know?
Other than that, it was mostly unassuming. I actually kind of liked a lot of licensed music. Like Aquaman had his, wherever he was there, you're going to get some rock going.
Yeah, he had the white stripes.
Yeah. Like, all right, that's cool. I kind of wish they would have done that for just gave everyone else kind of their own specific, like Cyborg, nothing.
Mr. Roboto or something.
Yeah. Wonder Woman just had that guitar riff, that admittedly good guitar riff.
Yeah, I like that.
But
I like
your
theme.
Yeah, I wish they could have given a little bit more than that.
Yeah.
But yeah, I mean, other than that, the music was rather unassuming.
All right, man. So how do we end this review?
It's worth a rental if you can find some place that rents movies. I mean,
so is it worth going to the theaters to see? Or should people just wait and go see Star Wars?
I'm having my own misgivings about that as well. But
all right, you're done talking.
I would definitely wait. You're done. I'm saying you're setting yourself up for disappointment.
There is no trashing Star Wars on this show. So, Sean, you are done for the moment. Thank you for being on the show.
Oh, thank you for having me. I'm getting in on the Star Wars review, guys.
No, you're not.
I am going to be here.
No, I'm sorry. Sean is done. He is. He's gone. He's out. I am Chris. I am out as well. We're going to be back in a few minutes, and we're going to be doing a theme show of John F. Kennedy films, and we'll start off with the film 13 Days. It's coming your way next, right here on the Screen Team.